Thank you. Flying through the air, Innanzitutto offro i miei illimitati omaggi al mio maestro spirituale Srila Gurudeva Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Poi a tutti i sannyasi, a tutti i Vaishnava presenti e le Vaishnava presenti.
To all the sannyasis here present, to all the Vaishnavas. First he has to speak in Italian, then I will read and translate better.
Quando l'anima condizionata intraprende l'attività della Shutabhati, la Vidya, le Ananta e così via iniziano ad andarsene. Per questo dovremmo associarci con Vaishnava che sono snitta, affettuosamente predisposti verso di noi. E la sua e svajatia assiata nel sentimento di servizio d'amore da noi stessi desiderato. E solo dopo un lunghissimo periodo di tempo, un intero giorno di Brahma, in cui trascorrono mille Kaliyuga, Sri Chaitanya appare in questo mondo. Egli è Krishna stesso, che ha accettato la bellezza e il sentimento di Srimati Radhika. Egli è apparso a Mayapur, Srinivasvittana, solo per dare il tesoro più confidenziale e nascosto, misterioso persino ai devoti più grandi, il più sublime lettere del servizio devozionale. L'amore è il primo più elevato. Egli apparì per due motivi principali, gustare la dolcezza dell'amore per Dio e propagare il servizio devozionale nel mondo sulle basi della spontanea attrazione. Sri Chaitanya ha la speciale caratteristica di venire per stabilire Nama in Criso di Vrajaprema, lo speciale amore dei Vrijavasi per Krishna. Il Nama generico concede fino a Vaikuntha Prema, non oltre. Le glorie del Sadhu Sangha sono molto vaste, tanto che migliaia di volte non sarebbero sufficienti a trattare per intero l'argomento. Ci sono tanti tipi di Sadhu Sangha generici e noi li rispettiamo. Ma Srila Rupa Goswami ci ha istruito, oltre che a vivere a Vrindavana, di porci sotto la guida di un Vaishnava Rasikatapa Pragyana, vale a dire un'anima completamente realizzata, che ha la conoscenza globale di Shastra e che sperimenta la sua relazione con Krishna come Rupa Goswami e i suoi Rupa Vaishnava. Questo guru ci istruisce su come praticare la Bhakti e come sviluppare il nostro rispetto, affetto e servizio per Krishna. Ed inoltre attraverso le sue istruzioni, Edisha distrugge in noi i quattro stadi del peccato, Prarabdha, Uttabija, Aprarabdha e Avidya. Seguendo questa istruzione di associarci con i guri devoti, otterremo la misericordia di Krishna, che esteriormente, chi esteriormente fa mostra di essere un Vaishnava, non manca di onorarli, dando la priorità alla fama e al guadagno materiale, non può essere di aiuto a sviluppare la nostra parte. Se si desidera il servizio devozionale condizionato per Krishna, bisogna associarsi con Vaishnava qualificato, altrimenti il risultato sarà Asat Sangha, associazione di materialisti. Dico questo perché non si può illudere o far finta di niente, come se Sri Chaitanya o Sri Nityananda non fossero venuti. Parlare di Krishna Kurukshetra e della Gita oggi non è sbagliato, ma va sicuramente posto nell'ottica della meravigliosa nuova misericordia di Sri Chaitanya, se non si vuole essere offensori o aridi predicatori. Esiste la pure dei dibatti e quella impura. Shravana Kirtan eccetera svolti con la sola intenzione di dar piacere a Krishna è vera dai dibatti, ma Krishna non è compiaciuto nemmeno dalla vera dai dibatti. Lo è solo se si serve in sakya, fazzale e madhurya bhava, come fanno i Vrajavasi. Associarsi con qualcuno che può insegnarci i veri sentimenti di Krishna è molto raro, persino a Vrindavana. Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj è questo tipo di Vaishnava ed è per questo che abbiamo organizzato questo festival, in sé che è sì una festa, ma la festa della Shuddhavati, di Shravana e Kirtana, dell'ascolto e del ricordo. Felici in associazione del Vaishnava e con la grande fortuna della sua personale presenza. Srila Gurudeva è di aiuto per tutti, perché è proprio come Mahaprabhu, che danzando davanti al carro di Jagannath ispirava tutti, ognuno ai vari livelli di bhakti sviluppava il vivo desiderio di raggiungere lo stato successivo. Così chi ascolta, vede e soprattutto serve la missione di Srila Gurudeva è ispirato ed aiutato a raggiungere un superiore grado di bhakti. E questo ci aiuta a non disperare e non perdere la speranza. Raggiungere la Shuddhavati è possibile. Molti di noi erano soli, preferivano non prendere alcun tipo di associazione, delusi e da esperienze precedenti e molte altre cose. Srila Gurudeva Narayana Goswami Maharaj è soddisfatto in se stesso e svolgeva felicemente il suo bhajan di alta classe a Mathura, ha iniziato a viaggiare in tutto il mondo come prima di lui la Trivenanta Swami Maharaj, al solo scopo di ispirarci e darci supporto. Solo Gurudeva e quelli come lui erano invidiosi e contrari ad alcuna invano. Se Krishna decide, chi compirà che cosa? Solo Duryodhana e quelli come lui troveranno da ridire. Il vero risultato della coscienza di Krishna non è mai determinato da fattori o qualità materiali, ma solo da Bhaktidevi, la potenza interna di Krishna. Così è per espresso il desiderio di Krishna di Srimati Radhika, che Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj riscopre successo. Sevaka indica colui che rende servizio. Servizio significa seguire la volontà di Krishna, non disquisire sulla sua volontà ed opposto. Se noi apprezziamo, ciò soddisferà Krishna e simultaneamente inizieremo a far nostre le qualità individuate e aggiustate. Le Babbagive, se si trovano qui in questo mondo, è perché in un modo o nell'altro hanno invidiato Krishna, hanno pensato di poter essere goditori separatamente da Krishna. Perciò non coltiviamo ulteriormente questo sentimento di separatezza. Il Vaishnava, il Guru, non agiscono per un piano materiale, ma esclusivamente per il bene delle anime condizionate, di tutte le anime condizionate, a qualsiasi religione pensino di appartenere, che dire di chi in un modo o in un altro canta Hare Krishna e fa parte della Gora Bazzara, la famiglia di Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Questo festival è aperto a tutti, lo spirito che ci anima e che anima particolarmente Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj, testimoniato nella sua intera vita con uno spirito di aiuto e misericordia verso tutti. Ma è testimonianza in tutta la comunità di Vaishnava il fatto che non è mai stato interessato al discepolaggio, ma con la sua più magnanima attitudine ha sempre istruito, spiegato, fornito shiksha a chiunque ne dimostrasse interesse. Con molta liberalità, lui è in particolare questo tipo di Vaishnava. E guru, la sua gloria sta in questo. Ad un certo punto ha iniziato a svolgere anche l'altra funzione di dare diksha, ma la sua attitudine e gloria è inalterata. Ed ancora più grande, dobbiamo sapere che tutte queste cose e che Vaishnava ci troviamo davanti. Ci sarebbero molte altre cose più intime e dolci da dire sulla sua personalità. Questa è solamente una traccia. Apprestiamoci con tutto noi stessi a partecipare a questo festival di Arigatà di alto livello. Siamo tutti estremamente fortunati in questa notte di Kali Yuga a trovarci sotto la luce della stella più brillante di misericordiosa di Krishna. Srila Gurudeva, Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Hare Krishna.
From all over the world, this, only because a first class associate of intimate associate of Shishi Mother Krishna is here with us. And by this association, we have a chance in 1,000 yoga, we got a million of girls, we got a chance now. So we hope that we can take advantage and not only appreciate, but also serving and following always.
Yeah. Tasmai Shri Gurve Namaha. Pancha Kalpatirupascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Pratiktanam Pavadibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. First of all, I'm offering my unlimited Dandavat Pranams, my Shraddha Pushpamjali, to the lotus feet of my beloved Gurudev, Nitya Lila Vishnu, Om Vishnu Pad, Pashtotar Sata Shishima, Isi Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada. And secondly, my equal number of pranams, my Shraddha Pushpanjali to the lotus feet of my beloved Sikh Shadura Devas. Nityalila Adha Vishnu, Om Vishnu Pad, Astutam Sata Shrishya, Bhakti Raksha, Sridharava Swami Maharaj. And Om Vishnu Pad, Astutam Sata Shrishya, Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Our beloved Gurudev. Also, my Dandavat pranams to all my Rupa Nuga Guru Varga and to all the Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, friends, and guests who have come to this very, very auspicious spiritual assembly under the auspices, the guidance of our spiritual master, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Maharaj. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to tell the reason why he has come here, why all of us have come here from so far away. What is the actual purpose of gathering here together? Is it only a social event? Is it some way to occupy our time away from our ordinary lives? Or does it have some very essential and very important purpose in our coming here? So as Lila Purushottam Prabhu was explaining, it is very, very rare for any living being in this world to come into contact with a self-realized, a God-realized personality. It's extremely rare in this world. Actually, in the Vedic literatures, 5,000 years old Vedic literatures, there it is told that all living beings within this material world, they are wandering here and there, lifetime after lifetime, in many, many different births, not only in human species, but every soul is going through 8,400,000 different species of life, coming from aquatics up to the insects, the plants, the creepers, the birds, the animals, and finally having the chance to obtain human birth. In the human birth, it is very rare, first of all, to even get human birth. But actually, in that human birth, if we become civilized human beings, then we come in connection with the absolute knowledge which is given by the supreme creator of this world, the supreme personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. That is called Vedic knowledge. And following the teachings of the Vedas, when we have a chance to meet a perfected, realized spiritual master who can teach us the truth of the Vedic knowledge and teach us who we actually are, that we are not just these temporary physical material bodies that we all possess, but we are an eternal spiritual entity, part and parcel of the Supreme Absolute Truth, the Supreme Godhead, Sri Krishna. And we have been in this material world since time immemorial. That is called Anadi Kal, time immemorial. So when we get the opportunity to come into connection with such a realized spiritual master, it is indeed the most rare occurrence in any therefore, those souls who have this opportunity, how did it come? It came by many lifetimes of what is called Sukriti. Sukriti means pious activities which are performed in previous births, either knowingly or even unconsciously, unknowingly, and they accumulate like a spiritual bank balance. When it becomes mature, then what occurs by the mercy of the Supreme Lord, He allows the living entity to come into direct proximity with a pure spiritual master. And then, by the mercy of the Guru, by the mercy of the spiritual master, now he receives the seed of what is called the Bhakti Lata Bij. That means now the opportunity to begin our eternal activity of service to the Supreme Absolute Truth, Sri Krishna. Now it begins to awaken within our hearts. Some little dawning of faith, of Shraddha, begins to come into our hearts. And now the process of hearing very attentively from Sri Guru begins. That is called Bhajan Kriya. By constantly hearing from Guru, then all of the misgivings within the heart, all of the contamination that we have accumulated within our hearts for many, many lifetimes, it becomes cleansed away, and then we begin to realize our eternal spiritual nature. And that eternal spiritual nature is full of bliss, full of knowledge. So Sri Guru, the spiritual master, is in this world. He has come to give his association to all living beings who are fortunate in this way to come into his association. So Srila Gurudev, our spiritual master, has been traveling all throughout the length and breadth of this world for more than 13 years. And he is constantly giving his association in the form of his divine transcendental sound vibration emanating from his lotus mouth. And this sound vibration, this Shabda Brahma, it can directly go into our hearts and purify our hearts. And when that occurs, then we have the beginning stages of developing love for God, love for Krishna, which is called Krishna Prema. So Sri Guru has come here to give this to all. And those who are intelligent and fortunate souls, they have come here to receive that from Sri Guru. There is no other actual purpose of such a spiritual gathering as we have here today and for the next couple of days, other than to attain this great opportunity and this great good fortune to hear the divine message of Krishna Bhakti and Krishna consciousness from the lips of a pure devotee of Krishna. So we are very fortunate that we have had this opportunity to come here. We are very, very happy that our Gurudev has come, even though there was some delay. But now we have the chance to hear from his divine lotus mouth the message of pure Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna.
Bhaktati Srila Gurudev, Nitya Lila Purushottam Vishnu Bhava, Sri Srimad Bhakti Pradyamati Sarasa. And so the Rati Bhakti Siksha Guru, Nitya Lila Purushottam Vishnu Bhava, Astota Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Sarasa. My old sannyasi teacher, Vaishnava and Vaishnava. I have come in these 4 days, even Bhaktasa who have taken me not to travel so much, but I am coming because our previous guru, Narada Goswami, he used to go door to door because he was so merciful. You know, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he went everywhere in India, east, west, south, everywhere. Without any suit or anything. Right? Out of mercy. So our Guru Parampara is this. And in them, their disciples are I come to remember you. That you are not this physical body. You are so part and parcel of Supreme Lord Krishna. You are eternal part of Krishna. But we have all fallen. And that is why from the beginning of creation, we are in circuit of endless pain, of endless birth and death. Old age coming, and another day. This is not the first time that you have come in human form. Previous, sometimes very poor, sometimes very poor. Sometimes very wealthy here, sometimes there are so many species, like birds, like animals, like donkeys, monkeys also, pigs and dogs. Well, but Krishna is so merciful that he has given this. So you must know that we are not. Especially I remember a story that once a Brahmin in Kashi, he did so much hard study for Shankar. And after some time Shankar appeared and told what when he gets in the mom. Then he told, I am a daughter, but I am very poor. I cannot be married to that my daughter. So I want some money, some wealth. Shankar told, you should go to Vrindavan. And there is a high class of Saint Sanatana Goswami. You should ask him to meet him. Oh. On foot, in so many months. 1 month he went there. And very easily he knew that where is Sanatana Prabhu. And he went to him. On the bank of Yamuna Nadi. And there Sanatana Goswami. He had nothing but only Goat walking.
Lion.
Nothing else. No bhajan putting. Nothing. When Dharam speaks, Shri Pranam to Sanatana Goswami and Ross, Sanatana Goswami and who are you? Oh, I'm a poor Brahman from Kashi. And Sankara told him that go to Sanatana Goswami and he will give some wealth to you. So I have come to you, Sanatana Goswami. So you see me, I am nothing. What I will eat in the beginning, that also I have. Sometimes without eating, drinking water. So how can I give you? I have no wealth. But throughout Brahman thought, Sankartan Kevila. Then Sanatana Goswami remembered something. Oh, come on, come on. Go there in the sand and there dig something, remove the sand and you will have something. He went there, removed the sand and he saw that there was a jewel. He took it and came to Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami told, bring some iron. Iron rods, and he brought. Then Sanatana Goswami had touched with that jewel. And when he touched, at once wonderfully he can go. Sanatana Goswami takes this, and he began very, very happy. And then he returned back. But in the way, he thought, oh, how costly this jewel is. But Sanatana Goswami had thrown it in sand. Why? And even he won't remember. Oh, he has something more. Then at once he turned back and went to Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami asked, why you turned back? I thought that so costly valuable this jewel. But you don't remember you have turned in the sand. So I think that you have more and more costly than this. I want that. Oh, really you want? Yes. And so he took Jamuna, very far away. And then Brahmin at once took that jewel and thrown in the Jamuna, very far away. And then Sanatana Goswami told, now you should take bath and come. And he went to Jamuna, took bath and returned back. Then Sanatana Goswami said, oh, this jewel, what tell of this jewel? Crores and crores, millions of these jewels. Can it be even had? What now I am giving to you? And he told, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. What is the meaning here? I am telling this story. You should think very deeply. We always neglect Harinam, chanting, remember. But we don't know the cost of this jewel. If you had Mustafa, it had been gone. But we don't believe. We give importance of money making. All this. If money is coming, we will give up. Oh, tomorrow I will change. Why? Bring with me. So many years with me, hearing the glories of name and work. Your wife, again married. Why all these desires coming? So I have come to remember all these things that came deeply. And then song, I remember, your life will be successful. You must know that your wife, your children, money cannot help anything at the time of death. You will keep here and empty hand, nothing to put in. So, even when it's time, let's follow the instructions of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We should know the glory, the value of Hari Ram and Bhakti. So I have come to remember you. Don't be attached to these worldly desires, intoxication, all other things. Don't believe any sannyasi should not believe. They said the more is strong. But all the brahmachari in the world, they should all be happy. By this, you will be happy. For this, I have come to remember. Because our Guru Parampara had given this time. Especially I went, came to Western countries and other countries to see the glory of my Shiksha Guru, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. When I came and I was in the tour of the whole world, everywhere saw all his glories. In a couple of years, everywhere we established Shiksha Center. Established duties. Oh, so many books he translated. And we, where I went, in the midst of jungle, on the top of the hills, and in the midst of the hills, everywhere I see his glory, I think anyhow, you have come to me. The reason is that you have read him, or you have seen him, or anyone. And he was very, very merciful to me. I stopped him from 1946. At time your birth was or not, I cannot tell you. And in the last time, he called me and took my hands in his hands and told, oh, I want that you should give me samadhi with your own. Though one Maharaj and others is God brothers with him, but why he called? Would have seen something? A special thing he told. And he also told, in Bengal, I have brought so many monkeys. I could not train them. So please train them. And also he told, I told, yes, I certainly fulfill your desire. So I did all these things, and in this succession, I'm touring the whole world. This is perhaps 26 times of my tour. Before this, everybody in the world, I gave classes on Srimad Bhagavatam, three pastimes of Krishna. From Chaitanya Charitamrita, Raramana Sambhava, Ratha Jatra Festival, Rup Siksha, Raramana Siksha, besides so many subjects. So, some devotees advised me that Jagadananda Prabhu Bhakti Association Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He had written a book about and it contains all the teachings of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all others. I want that you should read the Bhagavad Gita. So we begin in Veda on this subject, and here more 2 days I will try to discuss about any question. Jai Jai Radha Madhava Govinda, Jai Jai Radha Madhava Govinda.
Thank you.